Getting Real with Ashley Dawn. I want to talk to you about relationships. And you're like, Ashley Dawn, you got like 5 videos on your page about relationships. I know, but I just wanted to talk about this one. And I would title it, I'll Be Me and You Be You. And we'll see what happens. So, often we have our lists, right? We have, I want somebody with dark hair and blue eyes, and I want somebody who drives a truck, and I want somebody who's a hopeless romantic, and I want somebody who's going to write me love letters and write me poems and sing me songs and hold my hand. And we have all these lists of things we want, right? And they're good, they're great, they're good, they're whatever. But very rarely do we realize that people are not meant to be like to fill in our needs for them. People are not meant to be like, we go to an ice cream store and we're like, okay, so I want vanilla ice cream and I want rainbow sprinkles, and then if you could dip it in chocolate, that would be awesome. Like, no, people are people. And so when you allow people to be themselves and they allow you to be yourself, then you can organically see if maybe God would have the two of you get married. Maybe God would have the two of you fall in love and spend the rest of your lives together. But so often we try to plan every single thing, and I want this, 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 and it's like, whoa, 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 whoa. It's not a paint by number. Your life is not a paint by number. It's not like, okay, the red paint goes here, blue paint goes here, the yellow paint goes here. A lot of time, it's you make the numbers and then God splashes the paint over it, right? And you're like, whoa, that doesn't match. Like, I had all this planned and God, you did this. That's why having a paint by number chart isn't a good deal. Having everything so rigid and not being able to bend and being like, this is the way it is, and this is the way it has to be. No, it's not the way that it is, and it's not the way that it has to be. You're not allowing God the freedom to change your mind. Have you ever changed your mind? I've changed mine. I've been at a drive-thru restaurant and been like, okay, I'm going to get this thing. And then I get up to the window and I'm like, nope, I'm going to get this thing, right? Sometimes you change your mind. I've been in a lot of relationships, and at different times I've been like, oh, this is it. This is it. And then I'm like, oh, this is not it. Right? Or you think somebody is just the bee's knees and they hung the moon, and then you get to know them and you're like, yeah, no, not going to work. Right? You can change your mind. You don't have to live a paint by number life. You don't have to have everything by the books. Well, I'm going to have a brand new car every year, and I'm going to have this house with this long driveway and this really cute mailbox, and I'm going to have this, and I'm going to have this, and I'm going to have this. Like, what a boring life. What a boring life that all you're concerned with is stuff, and all you're concerned with is how it fits your Pinterest board or how it fits your, you know, Facebook default picture. Could you imagine if social media went away? People would like have to like their lives. It wouldn't be anymore about doing things for the gram or doing things for Facebook or doing things for other people. And listen, I am not perfect. There have been times in my life where I have taken a picture with the like only purpose of posting it online. How shallow was that of me? That I cared more about strangers on the internet seeing a picture than I did about me actually living in the moment. That's something that I'm like, the older I get, the more that I realize life is so much less about other people and so much more about yourself. And I'm not saying to be selfish. I'm just saying we worry so much about being approved by others, about others being like, oh wow, you're really successful. Oh wow, you did a great job. Oh wow, your house looks awesome. Oh, your kids are so beautiful. Oh, your husband and you, your marriage looks so great. No, my marriage one day when I have one will not be for other people. It will be for me and my husband and God. I will be serving my husband to show my love for God, and vice versa. I hope he does the same thing for me. I will be loving my children out of the overflow of love that God gives me. It won't be so strangers on the internet can think I'm a good mom. I'll clean my house so that my family can live in a clean house, not so strangers on the internet can applaud how pretty my house looks. I actually, earlier this week, was like wanting to just get rid of all social media. Granted, for my job, I'm a speaker, so it's kind of necessary. But it's just sickening sometimes. And listen, I am not pointing fingers at other people that I'm not pointing at myself. I get sick of myself. I get sick of my own posts. And I'm like, why are you posting this? Are you posting this for other people? Are you posting it to brag? And a lot of time, I post things on my page or like with pictures. I'll upload pictures on my Facebook because I'm trying to delete them off of my phone. But then I have to think about it. Okay, if I don't want them on my phone, if I don't want them to be with me where I can see them, why do I care if strangers on the internet can see them? And so I have these like inner dialogues with myself quite frequently about, are you doing this for other people or are you doing this for yourself? Are you doing this for strangers on the internet or are you doing this for yourself? And if I'm being honest, which I always try to be, a lot of time I've done it for the gram. I've done it for people on the internet. My Pixie Dust and Pearls Instagram and Facebook, it's like a Disney based. There was a time where I was literally doing it every day and I wanted to make sure that I had a post every day. And granted, it started out, I just wanted to encourage people. And I went to Disney all the time. And so there was a lot of people that I knew from Disney that I wanted to encourage. So I'd post like a picture of Disney and then I'd post an encouraging message or scripture or something. But a lot of time I found myself at Epcot or at Magic Kingdom or at one of the parks taking pictures for the sole purpose of putting it on Instagram. Not because I wanted to take that picture, not because, and I've ordered food and spent money on food just because I wanted to do a review for my blog or for my Instagram. And it's like, whoa, I didn't even want to eat this. I literally just bought it to post it online. Like, crazy. And then I think about my life in high school. You know, I had a live journal, and I think in like the end of my high school, I had a MySpace, but I did things because I wanted to do things. I went places because I wanted to go places. And like, there's a whole chunk of my life that I really don't have pictures of because I was too busy living in the moment to stop and take a picture of it. And cell phones didn't have cameras on them back then. That's how old I am. So, but it's just like, I don't know. Maybe you're with me too and you're thinking like, I remember those days. Those were the good old days. Have you ever been to a concert and like stood there and listened to the concert? Not anymore. Now everybody's got their cell phones out. And it's like you just paid $75 to stand and to look at your phone essentially. You could have just watched this concert on YouTube. Why do you got to be here? You're not in it. You're not paying attention. And listen, again, I'm not pointing fingers that I'm not pointing fingers at myself. The same token. I've done that. I've gone places and I've been on my phone the whole stinking time. I went to a rodeo with my friend Gabby the other day and we took a couple pictures, but I made sure there was there was a bronc rider and I was doing a video of it and I caught myself and I was like, Ashley Dawn, do you want to watch this on a phone or do you want to watch this in person? And I was like, you know what? And I put my phone up. Or times where I videotaped something because I wanted to share it with somebody else and it was like, but do you care more about them seeing it or do you care more about you seeing it? And it's just, social media has such an impact. Like, psychologically, social media is jacking us up as a people. We are less social in person. We have less social interactions in person. Everyone's looking down on their phone. Everyone's, you know, constantly on their phone all the stinking time. And it's like, for what? For why? Why are they doing that? Why are they, why are they doing that? For other people. It's not for them. Nobody that I know of would pay extensive amounts of money to sit behind their phone. It ruins the experience. Have you ever been at a concert and somebody's standing right in front of you and you can't see the concert? Essentially, that's what a phone's doing. And I'm not saying don't take pictures. Yes, you can take pictures. I'm a photographer. People hire me to take pictures. But if you're at a concert for 3 hours, 3 hours of that concert should not be spent behind your phone. How about maybe you take some pictures, you watch the concert. You take some pictures, you watch the concert. Or maybe you take a whole bunch of pictures in the beginning and then you just watch the concert for the rest of the time. Or you watch the concert for most of it and you just take pictures at the end of the time. Right? What about that? I just know that I have really been looking inward lately and asking myself why I'm doing the things that I'm doing. Like, is this to fit a checklist? Is this to fit, you know, a paper? Like, for instance, okay, whole nother topic. My friend is a photographer and she's setting up these Christmas minis and they're really cute. There's a little pickup truck and there's like blankets and hot cocoa and everything. And I honestly was looking at these pictures and I'm like, oh, those are really cute. Like, those would be really cute to put on Facebook as a new default. And then I'm like, whoa, so the only thing you care about is updating your default picture. And I'm talking about myself. Like, this is in my head. And I'm like, why? Like, does that matter? Does that really matter in your life? No, it doesn't. It doesn't add value to your life. It doesn't necessarily take away value, but it doesn't add it to your life. What adds value to your life? Actual relationships, actual experiences. My daddy, I used to tell him all the time, like, Daddy, I'm going to Disney. And he loved that I went to Disney. He encouraged that I went to Disney. But he would tell me when I'd ask him if he wanted to go, he's like, why do I want to spend a whole bunch of money to look at fake stuff? If I want to go somewhere, I'll go to the Grand Canyon. I'll go look at real stuff. And he said it, and I understood it. But I was at Disney a couple years after he went to heaven. And I was walking around and I was looking at all these buildings, right? And they're made to look like different countries in Epcot. And I thought to myself, Daddy was right. You know, for an annual pass, it's like $1,000. Instead of going to a place and looking at fake countries, you could take that $1,000 and go to those countries. But we forget about that. And, you know, then we think about, well, I can take this picture and I can tag that I'm at Disney and I can do this and I can do this. But it's like, if social media went away, how much of our life would go away too? How much of our life would go away too? How much are we living for the gram? Or how much are we living for ourselves and living for God essentially too? Like, because I don't believe it's God's desire for us to live behind a phone. I believe it's his desire for us to go out in nature and to take our shoes off and to feel our, you know, our feet touch the dirt and the grass, to climb a tree, to go to the ocean, to go to the mountains. Like, one of the places that I recharge the most is nature. Sometimes I'll realize that I'm really struggling and I'm like, I'm struggling because I'm not in nature. I'm struggling because I'm not spending time outside. And I'll realize that I'll be like, you know what? You need to go to the beach, go to the mountains, go on a road trip, go just spend time in the country, go in nature. But so often we're so afraid to unplug. And here's another little side story. When I was doing my Instagram, my Disney one, and I still am, but when I was doing it more, I, you know, didn't want to miss a day because there's an algorithm and the more that you do it, the more views you'll get and the more people that will see it. And so I was looking at it and I'm like, if I don't post, it's going to mess up my algorithm and then it's going to mess up my content and then people aren't going to see it. And it's like, whoa, you're caring more about strangers than you're caring about yourself. You need to take a step away. You need to unplug. You need to turn your phone off. And just to be done with it, one of my friends, a really good friend of mine, he is never on his phone. Like, he's never on his phone. I think when we've hung out, he's been on his phone like for all of 2 seconds. And that was to check if he got a text from a job. But like, that's it. He was never on his phone. And he even said, like, he purposefully doesn't go on his phone. He purposefully tries not to go on social media, and he tries not to spend all of his time on his phone. And if he wants to talk to somebody, he'll call them. He'll go see them. He doesn't want to be on his phone all the time. And at first I was like, well, that's kind of weird. Like, how do people know what you're doing? How does this? How does that? And then it, like, after a little bit, I started thinking about, I'm like, I need to do that more. I need to turn my phone off more. I need to leave it in my purse more. Here's a scary thing. Have you ever left your phone at home? You kind of feel naked without it, right? Why? Because we have unhealthy attachments to technology. Because we have unhealthy attachments to strangers on the internet. To approval of people that doesn't even matter. And I'm talking about myself. I have lived for approval of other people. And you say, well, Ashley, don't. No, you don't. You're authentic and you're honest. And yeah, but when you're posting things online because you want a response from other people, and a lot of those other people you may not even know, like, yes, I have a heart that just wants to encourage and bless and help other people. But at the same time, my actual life that I'm living and the actual people that are in my life that I see on a day-to-day basis matter more than people on the internet. And I will say, you know, I'm not a mom yet, and I'm not a wife yet, but I will say, I think a lot of marriages and families are struggling because of phones. I think that, you know, moms are so hungry for connection with other moms that they neglect their kids. And I'm not saying it from a place of, you know, I'm better than you, because if I had a child, I might struggle with that same thing. I would probably struggle more with taking pictures all the time, and they'd be like, Mom, that's enough. Like, stop taking pictures of me. But husbands, you know, I've seen memes where the two people are laying in bed on other, like, the opposite sides, looking at their phones. And I know there's a lot of truth in that, that people do that. That late at night before people go to bed, they're making sure they see everything. Fear of missing out. They don't want to miss out on nothing. They don't want something to happen that they don't know about. And I just look at that and I'm like, how many marriages are struggling because people are turning to attention from strangers instead of attention from their spouse, instead of attention from their husband or from their wife? I don't want to be that kind of person. Lord, please help me. When you give me a man of God, when you give me a husband, please help me. Okay. Please help me not to be that way. Please help me not to do those things. Please help me to love the person that I'm with and to focus on the person that I'm with and to give them my attention. And to never choose a phone over an actual relationship. That's my encouragement today. Don't paint by numbers. Don't look for attention on a phone. I hope this encouraged you. It encourages me. You are seen. You are celebrated. You are loved. The people in your life matter. You matter. And I'm thankful for you. I hope that you have the most beautiful day today, and I hope that everything in your life turns around for your good and God's glory. Catch you in the next one.